There is this fail-safe comment that I'm sure everyone has heard once, especially in the hip-hop community, and it goes like this. I make music, or I rap, or I produce, or whatever artistic endeavor it is, for the love of it, not the money. And let's just be clear about my thoughts on this. I firmly believe that that statement is an excuse. And it's a good excuse. It's a clever phrase that makes the person or the people that you say it to feel as if there's something wrong with promoting yourself. And it makes the person who says it look like they really mean it. And while there's nothing wrong with doing anything for the love of it, but there is a problem when you don't have the means to even do what you love. And this brings us around to the topic of self-promotion. At the root of it all, there are a lot of us out there that are ashamed to promote ourselves. And that's it. That's bottom line. So we say little phrases like that to deflect the core problem here. And why are a lot of us ashamed? There could be many reasons, some stemming from issues that have nothing to do with music. But a lot of the time, one of the major reasons is self-worth. A lot of us do not believe in the very art we make. There was a time when I wouldn't even let somebody hear anything that I was doing until it was completely finished, or I felt it was good enough for somebody to hear. Not because I wanted to present my music in its best possible form, but because I was ashamed of my music. I didn't believe it was good enough. And as I followed that thought process, I felt, well, if I am ashamed and don't feel my music is good enough, that means someone else is really going to not think it's good enough. And that thought of somebody not liking what I do, just the thought now, would ultimately make me feel as if I shouldn't be pursuing music at all. And I'm sure I'm not the only one who's felt like this. Why? Because I've heard and seen the same pattern of behavior from other people. So before we even get to the topic of self-promotion from a business standpoint, I want to tackle the mental aspect of it. Self-worth starts in the mind. And I like to speak about the power of thought a lot because that is where everything starts. And where you personally have to start is to realize your self-worth. Realize that not everyone can do what you do. There are more people that can't put together a musical idea than there are people who can. And to carry that further, there is nobody that could put together a musical idea like you can. There is only one you, and there will only ever be one you. And this is why it's important to cultivate your own sound and take the risk of being yourself. Because from a business standpoint, it is very, very profitable. There is no way somebody could be a trailblazer based on your original ideas before you. You are the author and originator of your own style. It's a very powerful position to have. However, if you choose to follow somebody, you will always be trailing behind that person. There will only be one Dilla. There will only be one Pete Rock. There will only be one Primo. That's it. They took the hard road of standing out alone and developing their own style. Yes, they've drawn on ideas from other people and been inspired by other musicians, but their style is filtered through their personality, and that can never be duplicated. So when you look at promotion from the mental aspect, you realize that you hold a very, very powerful card in being original. So I would say that's step number one. And we'll continue this conversation and discuss steps number 2, 3, and 4 and how many others I can come up with as we go. But that's it for this video. Thanks so much for listening. Take yourself over to thedaydreamsound.com and pick up my albums. My latest, Formations in Rhythm, is the bomb. No more to be said. I love that album. Subscribe to me here on YouTube. Follow me on Facebook. Follow me on Twitter. Get on my Instagram. And something new. I've been slowly but surely reviving my SoundCloud account. I'm posting regularly, and for the first few hours after I post something new, it will be downloadable for a couple hours. So you'll have to act quickly. How will you know when I post? Very easy. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter and everywhere else, and you'll know. And of course, you can find out everything that I'm doing at thedaydreamsound.com. Take care of yourself. See you on the next one. Peace.